I am very happy to be here. It was several times planned, this visit, but due to the changes in Latvian political life, it was possible only now, because we have a lot of issues to discuss with Latvian government. I will say some words about European general transport policy and how it stands today and how it looks today. First, what I must say is that during this year and a half, or a little more, two years, the European Commission has substantially raised the profile of transport policy. When we started at the beginning of year 2010, transport was mentioned only as a problem, as a nuisance, creating mostly CO2. Today it's more balanced. Nobody denies the challenge concerning climate change and the need to reduce CO2 emissions. But we see also much larger picture that transport is a part of very important part of economy. Transport gives revenues in Europe to 10 million people. Huge and very important decision was Commission proposal, budgetary proposal for multi-annual financial framework, European budget for years 2014-2020. And I must underline that this was it's politically and also technologically very difficult decision, because everybody understood that budget will not grow. And still, inside this budget, there are two important moves were decided. One, to increase money for research and development. Another, to create the so-called Connecting Europe Facility, to invest in infrastructure, in information technology infrastructure, energy infrastructure, and the largest part for transport infrastructure. This proposal is the biggest investment proposal of European Union forever. Ever. Such a decision has never been made before. This March will be the decision, will be the general approach adopted in Council, where first reflections will come out what will happen to this trans-European network. This is the idea to have certain network of really projects with European value. And because the existing trans-European network in very large extent is a compound of or as we say, patchwork of national projects, and not very is not addressing very seriously and very effectively the cross-border issues and trans-European issues. We try to have a new network project which is much more linked together and is a real network. This is a basic discussions about it. So we need to have a bigger picture, and this big picture is described by the trans-European, 10 trans-European main corridors, and we have financing tools to this 31.7 billion euros in Commission proposal, which is a big amount of money. Priority of this 10T network is one big priority is better connections between eastern part of European Union with western part of European Union. And so you must have also special tools for this, and you must have special projects for this. And the special tool is 10 billion euro money in this Connecting Europe facility, which can be used based on cohesion money rules, which means co-financing up to 85%. Now we need projects and concrete ideas, and definitely one most interesting idea here is a rail Baltic, or it's Rail Baltica was but the linguistic people said that this is completely wrong to call it Rail Baltica, it's Rail Baltic. We discussed also the possible relations between the North-South corridor, which is a very interesting one. It's a very big interest expressed in latest times also by countries south or more to the middle of Europe, like Slovakia, Czech Republic, who also are interested in having some kind of connection to north. So it's Baltic, it's not only a dream of our areas here to have a connection. So I think that we have historical moment. Europe is an integration. Integration must be also not only in legislation and other things, but also in infrastructure. And this Rail Baltic is a great symbolic value. So when people say that there is no economic ground, this is not true. There is a lot of economic ground, but this is a very political project. This I agree, this is a political project. In terms of this is symbolic project, it's very symbolic. And it is the first project which creates Baltic as a region. This is a Baltic integration project and Baltic identity project, and also I must say that this is a historical moment now to progress with this project. It's this moment probably will not come in the future anymore.
Piekrītot tām nostādnēm, ko komisāra kungs minēja, es tomēr gribēju akcentēt uz divām problēmām, kas skar autotransportu. Jūs jau minējāt attiecības ar Krieviju. Protams, pirmais tā ir robežu šķērsošana. Es jums tik minēju pāris ciparu, tādā ik gadu pārvadātāji zaudē 15-20 miljonus eiro gaidot rindā uz robežu ar Krieviju. 80% šie zaudējumi ir Eiropas Savienības pārvadātāji, tātad varat rēķināt, kā tie cipari ir. Teiksim, ik gadu, teiksim, pagājušajā gadā 480 mašīnas ik dienu gaidīja uz robežu šķērsošanu. Protams, mēs veicam pasākumus, lai atvieglinātu. Es zinu, ka man igauņu kolēģi ir jau ieviesuši elektronisko rindu reģistrāciju, to mēs arī ejam to pašu ceļu. Bet jebkurā gadījumā mēs tomēr gaidām zināmas aktivitātes, varbūt ievērojamas aktivitātes no Eiropas Savienības, pat cik tā ir Eiropas Savienības robeža, un tie zaudējumi nes, es domāju, visiem šo tādu negatīvu efektu. Otrs jautājums saistībā Eiropas tomēr to kopējo politiku, transporta politiku. Tomēr mēs jūtam arī Eiropas iekšienē, Eiropas Savienības iekšienē, ir tomēr lielās valsts, mazās valsts. Un es varu minēt arī konkrēts piemērs, teiksim, kāda ir, teiksim, ir tāpat Itālijas attieksme, atļauju ziņā, Vācijas attieksme, Polijas attiecībā uz mazajām Baltijas valstīm. Tomēr šai politikai, domāju, jābūt vairāk vienotai, pat cik mēs esam Eiropas Savienībā, un mums ir viens tirgs.
This is not, there are several issues. First is that border crossing is not transport people. It's not in the hands of transport people. It's customs and Ministry of Interior. And this is problematic also. I understand that the relations, other side of border are not so clear and so constructive. Land transport with neighboring countries is poorly in the hands of member states. Of course, small countries, I know the Estonian situation, the same. Of course, they cannot do too much with Russia, that's for sure. Now, about, if I understood now correctly about the discrimination, there should not be any discrimination. It's, one thing is the cabotage rule, which means, which is absurd, and from our side, it is our clear objective also written in our white paper that this cabotage should be abolished. So it's free, must be free market. But, if you have concrete examples where you really can show the discrimination of Baltic drivers concerning the administration or related to administration of European member states, we can of course, give a certain, we can process it and ask questions and send letters and maybe even launch infringement procedures. It's possible.
Man ir jautājums pēc jūsu vizītes šeit Latvijā, kas tuvojās beigām, un pēc tikšanās ar augstām amatpersonām, arī ar ekspertiem transporta ministrijā Latvijas dzelzceļā, es pieņemu Kāds ir jūs, kā jūs redzat to optimistiski vai nevisai optimistiski šo situāciju divos aspektos, tajā lietā, ko jūs prezentējāt? Pirmais aspekts. Kā jūs droši vien jūtat, šeit Latvijā tiek pretnostatīts Rail Baltica ātrvilcienu projekts pretēji elektrifikācijas projektam austrumu-rietumu virzienā. Jūs gan minējāt, ka jūs tā pats neuzskatat, ka šie projekti abi ir pamattīklā, viens ir prioritāte koridori ziemeļ-dienvidu virzienā un austrumu-rietumu elektrifikācijas projekts lieliski iederās pamattīklā. Pie tam, kā mēs zinām, naudas plūsmas ziņā no šo projektu apgūšanas nākošajā finanšu perspektīvē Latvijai šķiet, kad ir pietiekami naudas finansēt abus projektus tajā daļā, cik tas ir. Vai jūs sajūtāt no Latvijas autoritātēm vēlmi nenostāties, nepretnestatīt šos abus projektus, līdz ar to padarot vājāku Rail Baltica realizāciju kopumā, kas nepārprotam izskar no Latvijas dzelzceļa vadītāja puses šonedēļ, kas man šķiet absolūti nepieņēma Magoņa kunga, personām. Otrs būtisks jautājums jūsu TNT vadlīniju virzienā. Vai jūs redzējāt izprat no gan no premjerministra, gan no citiem, ar ko jūs tikāties, par to, ka šis jūsu pieeja Connecting Europe Facility, šo 10 miljardu iezīmēšanu virs nacionālām kohēzijas aploksnēm kā saprotamu pieeju? Vai jūs jūtāt izpratni par šo? Paldies!
We had intensive discussions also in ministry for transport about these issues and for me different interests are totally understandable when people have developed direction, east-west directions and it's of course it's logical to expect that this also bring some profits. And in my view, these two directions don't contradict, but of course the magnitude is different. The Rail Baltic is part of Baltic Adriatic or Baltic Rotterdam or whatever, but so far written Baltic Adriatic corridor. This is one of the most important corridors. This is a really important and very symbolic project also for our priority, the Commission's priority to have this east-west in European Union. It's the integration by infrastructure. It's a huge project. So this will have much more money available. This is the answer. But of course we can also accommodate and try to find ways to combine these interests. That's also east-west connection is in core network and there are a lot of things which can be done with available resources, but magnitude is the big one, is north-south corridor. You asked that am I optimistic? I am always optimistic. No, but we had very constructive meetings in all at all levels where I met people.
Paldies jums par jūsu komentāru, kur es gribēju uzsvērt šobrīd visiem klātesošajiem. Ka mēs varam šo Rail Baltica projektu mainīt, kā mums gribās. Tāpēc, ka biznesa sabiedrība šobrīd viņu lielā mērā, arī tie, kas atbalsta, uztraucās par to, lai tas nebūtu ātrvilciens, kas lielā ātrumā 20 km attālumā no Rīgas pabrauc mums garām, un mums par to vēl jāmaksā. Un tas ir pats galvenais, ka jūs teicāt, ka mēs viņu varam mainīt, kā gribam, jo tad mēs redzam tam jēgu, un tad mēs arī vieglāk varam to atbalstīt. Un otrs bija tehnisks jautājums par to, kad muitas punkti ir sastāvdaļa no transporta koridora, un mums, kā te Treziņa kungs pašā sākumā jau arī iestrādāja savas domas, mums regulāri uz Ziemassvētkiem stāv pār pa 1000 mašīnām uz robežas, un muitas pārējais punkts uz Krievi ir ļoti svarīgs. Savukārt, kad mēs skatāmies uz regulējumu, tad Krievija it kā neizskatās, ka viņa pilnībā kvalificējās kā valsts, kur mēs varētu būvēt un dabūt šos te fondu atbalstus tieši robežu pārējām uz Krieviju. Kā jums liekas, tur visi kārtībā mēs varam, jeb tur varbūt vēl vajag kaut kādas uzlabojumus. Kā tur ir ar Krieviju? Muitas punktos, paldies.
First of all, the route of railway or Rail Baltic, it was very interesting to know that this was proposed by representative of representatives of three countries to AECOM studies, that this should be the route. And probably I think that historically people really thought that this will be a 350 kilometers per hour train which must go very straight. Today, of course, we are not discussing the 350 kilometers per hour. We are discussing the much more modest speed, 200-something, which also doesn't require the different level crossings. It's clearly elaborated in your administration, in Ministry for Transport, and probably Ministry of Transport has a lead in designing a route which goes for passengers through Riga and for cargo as well. They showed me to us these lines, but it will be, and this will be obviously the part of the next study and more fine-tuning or detailed study. But of course, the route will be as you wish. It's absurd to nobody else will design this route, and of course there must be stops and all these things. It's all process of real project. Why do you think that we should finance border crossing points, Russian border crossing points? In Estonia, European Union financed some kind of parking facility for where cars can, trucks can wait, and also to electronically to fulfill the custom modalities. This we can do, but it doesn't depend. The border crossing doesn't depend on European Union, and in Estonia, my Estonian friends have numerous times raised the same issue, and they show also that how it's limited, and suddenly all officials on Russian side disappear for 3 hours. We cannot help to change this situation, and border crossing is not the transport problem mostly. It is border crossing is a problem of border guards and the passport control and customs and the hands of other institutions. So I don't think so that European Union will support some development on Russian side.